In 1347, an unimaginable nightmare lurked on the horizon. It all started with a brutal siege. The trading port of Caffa was left trapped, without supplies, and desperate for a miracle. Seemingly out of nowhere, Yani Beg, leader of the Mongols, promised to retreat. His soldiers had mysteriously fallen ill. Many were dying. Before leaving, Yani Beg offered his enemies a sinister parting gift. His army catapulted the corpses of plague-infected soldiers into the city. The Black Death had officially arrived in Europe. From Caffa, the plague spread like wildfire, ravaging Europe, Asia, and North Africa. At its peak, the disease killed an estimated 25 to 30 million people in Europe alone, around one-third of the continent's population. This first massive European outbreak, bleakly nicknamed the Black Death, lasted just a few years, drawing to a close by 1353. But the devastation didn't stop there. Pandemics of the same plague persisted well into the 20th century. The plague takes three forms: bubonic, pneumonic, and septicemic. Bubonic plague, the most common and widespread form of the disease, causes painful, swollen lymph nodes called buboes, as well as fever, headaches, aching joints, nausea, and vomiting. Pneumonic plague is an airborne infection that affects the lungs, while septicemic plague infects the bloodstream, triggering symptoms like blackened skin from gangrene. In the 1660s, Europe experienced its worst plague outbreak since the Black Death. The disease wreaked havoc on the densely populated city of London, killing more than 68,000 people in just 1 year. Londoners could only guess at how the illness spread, but most believed that it traveled by air. To combat this, civilians burned dried rosemary, frankincense, and bay leaves, hoping the smoke would purify their surroundings. Others burned old shoes. Some held oranges stuffed with cloves up to their noses. Realizing that the disease spread more rapidly through close contact, Londoners practiced what we now call social distancing. If weekly death rates rose above 30 people, city officials prohibited mass gatherings and shut down theaters. Quarantine measures were instituted, along with attempts to isolate and treat the sick. Sound familiar? But what really caused the plague? It wasn't until 1894 that scientist Alexander Yersin pinpointed the disease's source, Yersinia pestis, a bacterium carried by infected fleas on rats, which ran rampant on medieval ships and in cities. Although the plague largely disappeared from Europe by the late 18th century, periodic outbreaks still occur around the world. Luckily, cases are rare. And thanks to the wonders of modern science, we now have antibiotics to effectively treat the disease. And less catapults to deal with.